Ladies and gentlemen, I'm Nogat21, welcome back to Let's Play Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic. Last time, we entered the Starforge. Got ourselves some Starforge robes, which I think are actually worse than the dark side version, but whatever. Most dark side equipment is based on combat. Other than Tulak Horde's mask, which is absolutely fucking worthless to me. And the entire party at that. Anyway, we were slaughtering our way through the Starforge, and now we just had to take care of Bastila and kill Malak. Yay! And I don't actually know how long that'll actually take, so this is probably going to be the last or second to last. I'm not sure which now. Because this is the final area of the game. Let's find this door. Bastila!
Revan, I knew you'd come for me.
Well, kinda obvious we have to deal with you, Bastila. Since we didn't go to the dark side on fucking Rakata, we actually have to come here to save your ass. Because if we went dark side, you would have joined us again. Only this time, would have been a mess. And I'm not even... Why am I still stirring my coffee? Oh, because I can still feel some sugar crystals that haven't dissolved yet. I'll never give up on you, Bastila. I know you can still be saved.
You're wasting your time. I've seen the Jedi for what they are, weak and afraid. The Sith are the true masters of the Force. You've forgotten that lesson, Revan. Now you must pay the price. Here on the Starforge, the power of the dark side is at its strongest. This time, you will not defeat me.
Great. Oh boy. Oh, you're resisted. That's
I see now why Malak followed you. Even though you're only a shell of your former self, you're still a formidable opponent. I can't even imagine the power you must have wielded when you were the Dark Lord. You were a fool to give it all up and follow the light side.
You've been consumed by the dark side, Bastila. Can't you see it's destroying you?
The dark side has made me stronger than I ever was before. I have a greater command of the Force than all but the most powerful Jedi Masters. As Malak teaches me the greatest secrets of the Sith, I will unlock more of my potential. Eventually, there'll be no limit to what I can accomplish with the Force.
Malak will never let you become that powerful. He will kill you first.
Have you forgotten the ways of the Sith already, Revan? Eventually, I will challenge my Master. If I am worthy, he will die by my hand, and I will become the new Sith Master. Then I will take on my own apprentice, and the cycle will begin again. This is the way of the Sith. It is how we assure our leaders are always the strongest and most worthy.
The rule of two hasn't been invented yet. Why do they use this plot device here? Why? Oh. My God. It's so annoying. Now you're dooming yourself to an endless cycle of death and betrayal.
No, Revan. It is you who are doomed.
Oh, round two? And...
You're growing weary. I can sense it. Your strength falters. The light side is failing you while the power of the Starforge re-energizes me. Soon this will all be over.
Oh, this will be a good test. I'm going for this option. And strike me down, Bastila. I won't defend myself.
What type of trick is this?
I You're not evil, Bastila. You'll not strike down a defenseless opponent.
I am a Sith apprentice now. You place too much faith in what I used to be. And for that, you shall pay.
What was that about not defending myself?
This is not possible. You have rejected the dark side. You are a weak and pathetic servant of the light. How can you still stand against me? Why can't I defeat you?
Now you see the dark side is not stronger than the light.
Yes, I see you speak the truth. I am no match for you. Please, for the sake of what we once shared, do not make me suffer. End my life quickly. There is no other way.
I could never kill you, Bastila.
What other choice do you have? I have fallen to the dark side. I am the apprentice to the Dark Lord himself. You cannot let me live.
Well, I was redeemed, Bastila. You can be too.
You were a special case. The Council had no other choice. They needed you alive so they could discover the location of the Starforge. It was an act of desperation. It was my responsibility to watch over you, to make sure you did not slip back into your evil ways. I was supposed to protect you from the dark side.
Oh boy. Not very... not a lot of options to choose from here. Oh, I rag on this game too much, I swear. Eh, you did more than protect me, Bastila.
It's true I possess feelings for you. But was it only an illusion brought about by our bond? And what was the cost? Please, this is too painful. End it now, quickly. There is no other way.
Oh, boy. I don't even know if this will work, but sure, let's go with a cheesy romance. Why not? I love you, Bastila. I can't abandon you ever.
There is nothing in my heart but the blackness of the dark side. I'm sick of your preaching, Revan. I ask you for an honorable death, but you are too weak to even grant me that. No more words. This must end with blood.
Help us defeat the Sith, Bastila. This will atone for what you have done.
Yes. I could join you in your battle against the Dark Lord. That alone would not make up for all I have done. Yet it would be a step in the right direction. But how would you be able to trust me? How do you know I wouldn't turn on you when you faced Darth Malak? How do you know the Dark Side wouldn't make me betray you again?
I trust you enough to leave myself open to your attack, Bastila.
You play a dangerous game. Are you certain you wish to take this risk? I could end your life and gain Malak's favor with a single stroke of my lightsaber.
I won't, Bastila, because I love you and I believe in you.
You are brave, and some would say foolish. But you are also right. The dark side has not wholly consumed me. I cannot raise my blade against you. You will go on to defeat Malak, of this I have little doubt. You will have gone from being the Sith Lord himself to the savior of our galaxy. And you said you loved me. This may not be the best time to say it, but I love you too, with all my heart.
Well, it's about fucking time she finally acknowledged this. Oh, I hate this fucking cliche. True love conquers all. It's great for a children's book series, or a children's fairy tale, but in real life, it's a bunch of bullshit. You aren't afraid to love anymore.
After this? No. Nothing could make me feel safer than to be loved by you. You should go. Malak awaits. This isn't over yet. For any of us. I should stay here, though. If we face Malak, I am afraid his dark presence will overwhelm me. It would not be wise to expose myself to such temptation.
Well, you could use your battle meditation to aid the Republic fleet.
Yes, that would be for the best. You don't need me to defeat Malak anyway. Now I understand that a true Jedi is a match for any Sith. Even the Dark Lord himself. I will stay here in this chamber and use my battle meditation to aid the Republic fleet. I am their only hope of destroying the Starforge and ending the Sith menace. You must go and face Malak, but you have to hurry. Once I turn the battle in the Republic's favor, we won't have much time to escape the Starforge before it's destroyed. Good luck, my love, and may the Force be with you.
There. A break in the Sith formations. Green Squadron, move in.
Green Squadron, moving in.
You know, it's amazing they don't hit them.
Green Squadron's through. We've broken their lines. Mastala is no longer using her battle meditation against us. The tide has turned.
Red Squadron, into the breach. Capital ships, reinforce their position. Now's our chance. Infect Starforge with everything we've got.
Now that I think about it, do blaster bolts even disperse after a certain distance? Oh, great. I'm by myself. Fuck. Well, I didn't expect this. Shit. Well, I got three doors to choose from. Anyway. Actually, that's a good question. Do blaster bolts dissipate after a certain distance? I assume so. On a planet's gravitational pull, eventually the gravity will just pull the energy down. But in space, it keeps going until we either hit something or gets pulled to an opposite direction by a gravitational wave. Oh boy, why am I wondering about the physics of fucking imaginary energy blasts? Ay, ay, ay. Seriously, you think with that much fucking laser fire going around, it's not actual lasers, but you get the point, they would hit more things. Type B spike bin. What the fuck is this? It's empty. Terminal type B. Accessing droid generator internal system. Generator inactive. What the fuck is this? Terminal type A. Okay, I can't do anything because the generator is off. That's weird. But at least I'm not getting attacked every five steps. That's a plus. I guess we go through this door. Well, they're dead.
Oh. I tire of this game, Revan. You have been a thorn in my side from the moment I seized the mantle of Dark Lord from your feeble grasp. You made a mistake coming here, Revan. The Starforge fuels my command of the dark side. You are no match for me here, and this time you will not escape.
It's you who can't escape, Malak. Surrender, and the Jedi might show you mercy.
Is that what you call it? You think stripping away your power and your identity was an act of mercy, Revan? I would rather die.
Now, funny enough, there's actually, if I'm remembering this right, a cut ending where you could actually redeem Malak. It wasn't finished, obviously, but you can mod it in. So, technically, Malak could be redeemed. It's a pain in the ass to do so, but it could happen. but since I don't, this is an unmodded clean version of the game, which includes bugs and everything else that the PC port has, I can't do that, so I might as well take this train as far as it goes. I was safe from the darkness, Malak. You could be too if you wish.
Spoken like a true slave of the Jedi Code. Save your preaching, Revan. I will have none of it. You are an insignificant speck beneath my notice. I have surpassed you in every way and accomplished what you never could. I have unleashed the full potential of this Rakatan factory. You had no idea of the power within this place. Its very walls are alive with dark side energies. And now, my old master, I will let the Star Forge itself destroy you.
Well, that's kind of annoying. Hey, light side points gained. Not that it matters. Well, okay, I need to shut down these terminals. Oh. Oh, great. I know I have computer spikes. Thankfully though, these guys suck at combat. Wait a minute. The more of these I destroy, do more spikes spawn in the bins? Is that what's going on? If it is, that makes this a lot easier. Yes, yes, keep trying to shoot me. It's not working out so well for you. Boy, I got a shit ton of repair parts. Well, that's one down. So now I have literally infinite respawning dickheads. The old man decided to try a different roast this time. Well, technically roast, but medium roast with morning boost, apparently. I don't know what the morning boost means, but it tastes a little different than our usual coffee. Cooking a little longer than I'm normally used to is a good thing. Yep, the more of these robots I kill, the more computer spikes spawn. Disable this generator. And I gained 300 XP! I really wish there was no level cap in this game. I really wish there was no level cap in this game. I think there actually is a way to remove the level cap. I'm not sure if it's through console commands or through modding. I don't know why you droids have to make that sound effect. I kind of wish I had higher force regeneration. You know, for infinitely spawning droids, these guys are rather good. Which makes a lot of sense, but they're a lot stronger. That's 5 spikes. You know what, Master Speed just makes you go faster. Disable. Yay, another 300 XP. Get spikes from it. Makes sense. There's 8 right off the bat. Ah, 5 more. Perfect. Did I loot type B? I think I did. Yes, I did. Type B. Sable. I'm gonna go with you guys because you're annoying me. Alright, it's time to deal with F. How many spikes do I have? I got 11. Disable. Now that there's only one bin left. Thank you. Now I'll deal with you. A rather annoying encounter, but not impossible to deal with. Oh, I need 2 more spikes. so let's just destroy you twice, and then call it a day. And it's good! Let's move on, shall we? Quick save, because I don't want to have to do that all over again. And let me guess, you fuckers dropped your lightsabers. Or useless crap. A med pack. That's all you gave me. A fucking med pack. Guess I shouldn't be so surprised. Ah! Big bad himself. Quick save, because I don't know what type of shenanigans I'm going to get into. I don't like that there's people in stasis fields right now. So I'm just going to pop that and,
Well done, Revan. I was certain the defenses of the Starforge would destroy you. But I see there is more of your old self in you than I expected. You are stronger than I thought. Stronger than you ever were during your reign as the Dark Lord. I did not think that was possible.
This is your last chance, Malak. Surrender.
No, Revan. This time our confrontation can only end in death. Yours or mine. Once again, we shall face each other in single combat, and the victor will decide the fate of the galaxy.
Oh, so you want a rematch involving your jaw? Well, I hope you learned your lesson compared to last time, because last time I kicked your ass. Oh, you made your saving throw. Impressive, sir. Oh! Wait, Malak?
You continue to amaze me, Revan. If only you had been the one to uncover the true power of the Starforge, you might have become truly invincible. But you were a fool. All you saw was an enormous factory. All you ever imagined was an infinite fleet rolling forth to crush the Republic. You are blind, Revan. Blind and stupid.
Is there some point to this?
The Starforge is more than just a space station. In some ways, it is like a living creature. It hungers, and it can feed on the dark side that is within all of us. Look around you, Revan. See the bodies? You should recognize them from the Academy. These are Jedi who fell when I attacked Dantooine. For all intents and purposes, dead. Except for one difference. I have not let them become one with the Force. Instead, I have brought them here. The Starforge corrupts what remains of their power and transfers the dark taint to me. You cannot beat me, Revan. Not here on the Starforge. Not when I can draw upon the power of all these Jedi. And once you are beaten, I will do the same to you. You will be trapped in a terrible existence between life and death. Your power feeding me as I conquer the galaxy.
Yeah, about that, Malak. Sith Emperor Vitiate. I'd never actually understood how to pronounce the fucker's name. Would like to speak to you about this little scheme of yours. Alright, time to start using some med packs here. And I'm being cheap. This is a problem. Only using the power of the Force could you free him now. Okay. You know what, Malak? You want to have your fucking infinite lives cheat code? I deny you your satisfaction. I deny you your validation of victory. Yeah, yeah, throw a lightsaber at me. Oh, you cheating shitbag. Oh wait, I forgot these guys. I wonder how many are left. Probably not that many. Well, Malak, it's been nice knowing you. I think I win.
Impossible. I cannot be beaten. I am the Dark Lord of the Sith.
The power of the... Yeah, that's a bunch of bullshit. The light will not be stronger than the dark, because the brighter the light, the bigger the dark. They belong in equilibrium and balance. Something that a lot of people don't seem to get. Even though I'm personally dark side all day, every day, 24/7, 365 days a year, even I can see the importance of having them be balanced out. One is not stronger than the other. But that's a piss-anti answer. I'm going with this. This is the way of the dark side, Malak. All things end in death.
Still spouting the wisdom of the Jedi, I see. Maybe there is more truth in their code than I ever believed. I cannot help but wonder, Revan, what would have happened had our positions been reversed? What if fate had decreed I would be captured by the Jedi? Could I have returned to the light as you did? If you had not led me down the dark path in the first place, what destiny would I have found?
Well, technically, you chose to follow. Exactly. You chose to follow your best friend no matter what, Malak, so this is entirely your fault, for the most part. Although, when Revan and Malak went into the Unknown Regions, that sealed their fate for damn sure. They should have just left enough alone, but no, they had to chase after the Mandalorians. I'm sorry I started you on this path, but you chose to continue down it.
I suppose you speak the truth. I alone must accept responsibility for my fate. I wanted to be master of the Sith and ruler of the galaxy. But that destiny was not mine, Revan. It might have been yours, perhaps, but never mine. And in the end, as the darkness takes me, I am nothing.
The mask does not go with the robes. Well, that takes care of that.
There you are. What happened?
Darth Malak is dead. It's over, finally.
That's wonderful news. There's no time to celebrate just yet. I was able to use my battle meditation to allow the Republic to break through the Sith fleet. The capital ships are in bombardment range.
And that means we all have to get out of here right now before this entire complex comes down around our ears. Everyone else is already on the ship. Let's move.
Gotta love that auto run cycle. Although I wonder, why are the Republic's blasters colored green? Shouldn't they be blue? Ah, whatever. Though I'm pretty sure you're not supposed to be that close to whatever you're supposed to be shooting at.
Admiral Dodonna, we've hit their main orbital stabilizers.
Everyone pull back. I don't want to lose any ships when that space station goes down. We did it, Vandar. The Sith are routed, and the Starforge destroyed.
But at what cost, Admiral? Where is the Ebon Hawk and her crew?
Figures to fucking alt-tabs me on the middle of a fucking cutscene. Assholes.
Fire, you made it.
We couldn't let you start the victory party without us, Admiral.
I'm sending an honor guard to escort you in. You'll be getting a hero's welcome when we all get home.
Well, someone liked episode 4.
You'll have defeated Malak, destroyed the Starforge, and broken the spirit of the Sith. For this, I am proud to present you each with the Cross of Glory, the highest honor the Republic can bestow. From Coruscant to the farthest reaches of the Outer Rims, you will be known as the saviors of the Republic.
You do know you're...
On behalf of the Jedi Council, defenders of the galaxy, and sworn protectors of the Republic, I, too, would like to honor you for your actions. We Jedi now have another tale to weave into the grand history of our Eternal Order. The redemption of Revan, the prodigal knight. Wherever you go, you will be recognized as the saviors of the galaxy, the heroes of our age. But you must remain ever vigilant, for one day, you may be called upon yet again to defend the glory of the Republic against the tyranny of the dark side. For this is the destiny of the Jedi.
Well, too bad that's never gonna happen. Well, someone clearly took the ending inspiration from, Episode 4. Although the dark side version, rather on whatever planet that was, is on Korriban. And Revan's Net was the head of a Sith fleet again. Oh well. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, this has been Let's Play Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic. My ending thoughts are, well... how can I put this into plain words? Good story, but some gameplay design choices are frustrating, to say the very least. A stupid bug involving mission side quest is inexcusable in my book. That should have been fixed. Without going into unofficial channels, such as modding, but what can you do? Developers are human too, and they miss some things as well. Unless you're Bethesda, who decide to say fuck it, and just ship it anyway. Why would you buy a Bethesda game on day one is beyond me. But anyway, other than that, I've been NoGod21, this has been Let's Play Star Wars, Knights of the Old Republic. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. After I take a few days off to recuperate, because holy hell do I need to set up the next one. That's gonna be a lot of fun, but until then,
Thank you.